Are passwords making you crazy? They seem to be getting more complicated and more frustrating all the time, but it doesn't need to be that way. Apple just released a brand new app called Passwords, and it's gonna simplify everything. Stick around, I'll tell you all about it. I'm Dylan Stewart, the MacWhisperer, and in this video, we're gonna talk all about Apple's new app, Passwords. This was released as a part of the iOS 18 and the macOS 15 Sequoia upgrades. And it's a fantastic program that gives you an easy way to access, store, organize, and even share all of your passwords. Make sure to stick around for my MacWhisper power tip because trust me guys, this one is awesome. So let's hop over to the phone and get started. The first thing to do is to locate where the Passwords app is on your phone. It should be on your home screen and it looks just like this. But if you can't find it, just tug down on your screen and go into search and type a couple of letters to pull it up. When you first open it up, it's going to scan your face or use your Touch ID or your phone's passcode in order to get started. Once the app opens up, you're going to notice all of these separate sections and categories. We're going to talk about most of them. Starting up at the top, you'll notice your little search bubble. This can allow you to immediately come in and search for any passwords you're looking for, making it easy to jump right onto that website. This app automatically synchronizes with the Apple Keychain, which many people are already using. But the Apple Keychain left things in a complicated place inside of your settings or inside of apps most people didn't use. By putting it into its own app, it makes it so much easier to use. So you can search up at the top for whatever password you're looking for, or you can click into the All section where all of the passwords are automatically stored here. It's organized alphabetically, but if you click on the little arrows in the lower left-hand corner, you can sort it in other ways like date edited, date created, or even the website name. Clicking on the plus button in the lower right-hand corner will allow you to manually create a password. But you don't generally need to do that, especially if you use Safari on your Apple devices, because when it's set up properly, it'll automatically add those new websites in or change the password if you change it on the site. But if you need to add it, you can add it right here, and this can be helpful for passwords that aren't website related. Like maybe you want to keep track of the password for your home security box. Things like that can easily be put in here. You can give it a title, a username, a password, and you can even add things into the notes section to make sure you've got all the information you need when you need it. When you're inside of the All section, you can search up at the top, or you can use the letters on the right-hand side to instantly jump to any particular section of your passwords. Up in the upper right-hand corner, you're gonna notice this little checkbox. Clicking that can allow you to select multiple passwords in case you're deleting a bunch of old ones or clearing out some of the ones you don't need anymore. Let's step out of the All section by clicking the back arrow here. To the right of the All section, you're going to see something called passkeys. Passkeys are a new system that allows certain websites to connect without needing an actual password. This works for sites like Amazon, and it means you don't actually need to know the password. It uses the biometrics on your devices. What are biometrics? Well, that's using your face ID or your fingerprint sensor in order to authenticate yourself to that website. It's easy to set up passkeys on most websites that support it. For this example, I'm going to open up the Amazon app on my phone and show you how to add a passkey there. For most websites, you'll need to log into that website and go into the security section to set it up. Let's hop out of the Passwords app and go right into the Amazon app here. From here, you need to get into your profile where you can make those changes. For Amazon, you do that by pressing on the little contact icon on your bottom bar here. This will open you up into your Amazon section where you can click directly on the Your Account button. From here, find your way down to Login and Security. Click on it. In order to do this, you'll need to log into the app, so I'm going to sign myself in. If you have two-factor authentication set up, you'll also need to put in your verification code. Let's do that now. Once you're properly authenticated and inside of your settings, find the passkey section. Sometimes it will be under the two-factor authentication section, but for Amazon, it's right here. If I click Setup, it'll take me right onto the page, and all I have to do is click that Setup button here. It'll confirm that it's going to use my Face ID, which is the biometrics on my phone, And if I click the continue button, it'll scan my face and immediately add that passkey right in. Now, if I come out of the Amazon app and back to the passwords app, you'll notice that under the passkeys section, there Amazon is, making it easy for me to connect to Amazon without even needing a password. Now let's go back to our home screen. On the left side, you'll notice something called codes. One of the ways we're protecting our accounts these days is through what's called 2FA or two-factor authentication. Two-factor authentication means that when you sign into a website or an app from a new device, it sends a 6-digit verification code to you, usually by text or sometimes by email, which is pretty convenient, except if you share that account with other people. For example, if both you and your wife are sharing your Amazon account, when it sends the verification code, it might send it to you when she needs it, or to her when you need it, making it complicated. There's a great way to solve that by using what's called an authenticator. There are several authenticators out there like the Microsoft Authenticator or the Google Authenticator, but now the Apple Passwords app can also act as an authenticator. If you want to use the authenticator, come into the code section here, and in the bottom right-hand corner, you're going to click the plus button. When you do that, you're going to be given the option to use the setup key for that website or to scan a QR code with your camera. In this case, I'm going to set up an authenticator for my Google account. Just like we did on Amazon a moment ago, you're going to have to log into that account first before you can add the authenticator code. In Google, it's done by opening up your Google account and going into the security section. Down in this area, you'll find the option to add an authenticator right here. Clicking that button will open up a page asking you to authenticate yourself to this account. Let's do that now. Once you get logged in, you'll set up the authenticator by clicking on this button. It will show the QR code on the screen or give you a setup code if you want to use it that way. The next thing to do is go back to your phone and click where it says scan QR code with camera. When you click that, point it at the QR code on your screen, it will immediately capture it and then ask you which website you want to connect it to. In this case, this is Google, so let's click right on that button there. And immediately, it's grabbed the verification code there. This is really helpful because rather than texting me a code every time I need to get into this account, the authenticator will store the code right here. And if you're using Safari on your Apple devices, the Passwords app can automatically enter that verification in so you don't even need to grab your phone or open up the Passwords app itself. That makes it super helpful and super easy to stay super secure with those websites. We're gonna skip the Wi-Fi section for right now, but I'm coming back to it with my MacWhisperer power tip, and trust me, you wanna stick around for that. Underneath that, we've got the security section. In this section, Apple will analyze the passwords that you've got and let you know if they're compromised. Compromise can mean that it's a very easy to guess password, or that it was a part of a data breach, or that that same password has been reused on multiple sites. If you don't want to see these compromised password alerts, we can turn that off in settings, which we'll get to in just a moment. But it's an easy way to know whether your passwords are safe and secure. And if you want to, you can click on any one of these passwords and click this button right here to go to the website and change that password directly from the website. To the right of that, we've got the deleted section. If you've been deleting passwords recently trying to clean things up and you deleted something by accident, they'll stay in this section for up to 30 days so that you can easily restore them if you made a mistake. Down below that, we've got something called shared groups, and shared groups are amazing. Essentially, it's the ability for you to collect a group of your passwords in one place and share them with anyone you like that's using Apple products. By clicking the plus button on new group here, you'll get the option to give it a name. Let's call it finance. If you'd like to share this group of passwords with other people, you can click the add people button right here in order to send them an invitation so that they can share those passwords. This can be very helpful for a husband and wife or a team that's working together and need access to the same websites. If you are sharing passwords and you change it on your device, it will change it for the other people as well so that everyone's always got the accurate password. Clicking the create button in the upper right-hand corner takes you to the next step. From here, you can choose whichever passwords you want to share into that group, And by using the search button at the top, you can easily find those specific websites. To collect all of the finance websites in one place, or all of the business websites, or all of the websites that you share with your family. In addition to the shared groups, you can also share your passwords directly with your family if you have a family set up in iCloud. This means that you can share with your wife and your kids so that nobody needs to bug you when they need to sign into Amazon or they want to know what your new password is for Netflix. This can keep it simple and make sure that everyone in your family has access to all of the passwords they need at any given time. So now that we know how to use the Passwords app, there's one more thing we need to do before we're complete, and that's talk about settings. In order to make this app work as well as possible, you want to make sure your autofill settings are proper on your devices. Open Settings up, and then go all the way down to the bottom where it says Apps. Here, you're going to hop yourself over to the P section and go into the Passwords app right here. In this section, you're going to see all sorts of options, like the ability to use the camera, which is important if you're going to scan QR codes. But the most important part is down at the bottom where it says View Autofill Settings. I'm going to click that. When you come into there, you want to make sure that autofill is turned on, and you want to choose your preferred app. If you've been using another third-party app like 1Password, you're going to want to turn the autofill onto the Apple Passwords app here. And down below there, you're going to see a section that says Setup Codes In, and you can choose from any app that has Authenticator capabilities. In this case, for me, that's Google Authenticator, the Passwords app, or RoboForm. Set up your preferred one right here, and you're all set up and ready to go. For the next section, we're going to hop over to the computer so that we can talk about some of the functions that are easier on the computer than they are on the phone. Let's find the Passwords app here on the computer. I'm going to click it open. It's going to need my fingerprint sensor in order to open it up. Easy enough to do. Once we're in here, you'll see all the same things you saw on the phone, all the separate sections, as well as the shared groups. I think it's a lot easier to create groups and do some of the functions from the computer. But the most important thing about the computer is the ability to import or export your passwords. If you've been using a third-party app, like 1Password or Bitwarden or LastPass, in order to track your passwords on your computer, you can easily export those out of that app and into the Apple system now, but you have to do it from the computer. And if you've been using Chrome, and Chrome has saved all of your passwords, you can easily export them out of Chrome and into the Apple Passwords app with the tips I'm going to talk about in just a moment. For me, I've been using a passwords app called RoboForm. Let's open it up right now. It's easy for you to export by coming into the File menu up here and finding the Export option. When you do that, it will ask for a password to authenticate you. In this case, I can use my fingerprint sensor again to authenticate, just like that. Now it's going to ask me which particular passwords I want to export. In RoboForm, I've organized most of my passwords into groups and folders. I don't want to export all of them. Let's just export the passwords from my family. I'll click on the Family folder here. Down below, you'll see different options for exporting. In this case, I don't need the bookmarks, I just need the logins. The format should be CSV. CSV stands for comma separated values, and it's a very, very common format that can be opened up with Microsoft Excel or with Apple's numbers in order to get access to the document. Up above, it shows the location this is going to export to. In my case, it's going to go to the Documents folder. Let's export it now. Once you've exported your passwords, go to your Finder and locate wherever they are. Open that document up just by double-clicking on it. It will either open up into Microsoft Excel or into Apple's numbers, depending on how your computer is set up. When you open it up, what I want you to notice is these titles along the top. Before you just import this into the Apple Passwords app, you need to make sure that the titles and fields are properly configured. They need to be the right names in the right order. You'll see them up across the top of your CSV document here. The ones that are showing on this page are based on RoboForm, and they're not quite accurate for what Apple's looking for. For Apple, the way you want to configure the fields is the first one should say title, and this is the name that you're going to associate with the website. It's different from the website because if you have multiple Google accounts, you'll want to make sure to differentiate yours from your wife's, from your son's. To the right of that, you need it to say URL. This is for the website that it's going to be connected to. Next to that, you want to use username spelled just like this for the username information, whether that's your email address, an actual username, or your phone number. And to the right of that, you want to have password spelled out just like this. There's also a field for notes and a field for OTP auth, which are those authenticator codes that you may already have connected to your Chrome or your third-party password system. Once you've cleaned up your password spreadsheet so that it looks like this, go ahead and save it, and then come into the Passwords app and go into the File menu at the top and choose Import Passwords. This will ask you to choose the file, select the file you just worked on, and all of those passwords will automatically get entered directly onto your computer. If you want to get off of one of those third-party password sites, or you want to change your passwords from Chrome into the Apple system, this is the best and easiest way to do it. If you continue to use Chrome on your computer, you may want to install the iCloud Passwords extension, which will allow your Chrome passwords to synchronize into the Apple Passwords app. Once you've got all your passwords in, you're ready to start organizing, cleaning them up, and sharing them with your friends and family, or using them on your iPhone, your iPad, and your computer. Suddenly, you've got a place for your passwords that's easy to find, easy to locate, and with you 24/7. In just a moment, I'm going to reveal my MacWhisperer power tip. But before I do, if you got great value out of today's video, give it a thumbs up. That makes it so much easier for other people to find it. And if you've got a question, a comment, something I left out, or something you want more information on, drop it down to the comments section. I love to hear from you guys. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, you're missing out. Maybe you don't want to learn more about your Apple products. Maybe things are good enough as they are. But if you're looking for more Apple tips and ways to make all of your Apple products work perfectly, hit that subscribe button and the notify bell so you're always alerted whenever I drop new content. And now, shoot, I forgot. What am I supposed to do here? Oh, right. The MacWhisperer power tip. Throughout this video, we've talked about some amazing tools and some great ways to use your passwords app. But if you'll recall, we skipped over one section, the Wi-Fi section. Why'd I skip it? Because what I'm going to show you is a game changer. First thing I'm going to do is click onto that section there. In this section, you will find all of the Wi-Fi signals that you've ever connected to and saved on any of your Apple devices. It's great that when you connect onto a Wi-Fi signal, it saves it so that you don't have to go back to your friend's house and keep asking what his Wi-Fi password is. But one of the problems is you don't always know what your own Wi-Fi password is, and it can be hard to find it. But now it's really, really easy. You'll notice all of your Wi-Fi passwords here organized alphabetically. The one up at the top is the one that you're currently connected to, and it shows in blue letting you know that's your current Wi-Fi. If you simply click on any of these Wi-Fi signals here, it'll open up this page, which will tell you the network name and show the password. Simply tapping on the dots next to password will show the actual password and give you the option to copy it or share it. But that's not the coolest part of this tip. The coolest part is this section where it says show network QR code. Let's click on it. As soon as you do, it's going to show a QR code for that Wi-Fi account that includes the password encoded into it. This means that anyone that scans that QR code can immediately hop directly onto your Wi-Fi. This makes it so much easier when guests come over to your house and you don't have to tell them what the password is because they can just easily scan it. Take a screenshot of that page, just like that, and then go into the screenshot, click on the share button in the upper right-hand corner, and print it out. Save that somewhere easy to find, and your guests will never bug you for your Wi-Fi password ever again. You're welcome. So that's what I've got for today's video. If you want more information about some of my password systems, check out this video right here. I'm Dylan Stewart, the MacWhisperer, and it's my passion and profession to help you get more done with your Apple products than you ever thought possible.